Western nations slam Russia over what they call false claims that Ukraine is preparing to use a so-called dirty bomb in its counteroffensive against Russian troops. NATO chief Jens Stoltenberg says Moscow must not use it as a pretext to escalate the conflict. Stoltenberg made the statement after speaking with Pentagon chief Lloyd Austin and British Defense Minister Ben Wallace. European Union official Joseph Borrell, meanwhile, says the International Atomic Energy Agency will be sending experts to territories in Ukraine where Russia falsely claims to be building a dirty bomb. A dirty bomb uses conventional explosives to scatter radioactive material. Moscow has warned in recent days that Kyiv could employ one, sparking fears that the Kremlin could use such a device and blame it on Ukraine. But a U.S. military official also says there's no indication the Russians have made a decision to employ nuclear or biological weapons. The sister of the alleged middleman in the Lapid-Slay case to be admitted to the government's witness protection program, the Justice Department, earlier took June Villamor's relative under its custody after she came forward with crucial information to determine the mastermind behind the killing. Joyce Valancia with this exclusive report.
Marissa, not her real name, flew to Manila on Saturday after receiving news that her brother Cristito Villamor Palanya, or more commonly known as June Villamor, was found dead in his cell in the National Penitentiary. June was one of the middlemen who ordered the gunman Joel Escorial to kill radio broadcaster Percy Lapid. Marissa said her brother feared for his life after his name was revealed during the investigation. While he was in prison, June had a cell phone that he used to send messages to her, including details of those who ordered to kill Lapid.
Noong 18 po, 11:59, bigla siyang nag-message. Sabi niya, Ate, kung ano man ang mangyari sa akin pag namatay ako, ingatan mo daw tong sikreto. Pag namatay ako, ilabas mo to. Pero hanggat buhay ako, tago mo to. Kaya pag nawala ako, ay parating kaila Jewel na ang nag-utos. Tatlo na commander dito. Sputnik, Happy Kulaki, at BCG. Galing sa opisina ang utos sa kanila.
At may nabanggit ho siya dun sa message na utos ng opisina. Opisina po ng alam.
Doon sa ano nila, doon sa Bilibid.
She also shared that her brother, Escorial, and the other middleman, Christopher Bakoto, knew each other for a long time.
Magkababariyo man namin yun, ma'am, si Jewel. Mm-hmm. Tapos yung isang middleman na sinasabi, si Christopher Bakoto, taga kabilang baryo naman.
Kilala rin
po
ninyo.
Opo.
Marissa admitted her brother could have really been involved in the case, noting that they had previous similar dealings. Her brother was sentenced to life imprisonment over a murder case.
Kasi yung mga kasama niya, si Jewel, tas yan si Bakuto, may mga ano na rin yan dati na ganun. Baka nga siguro. Kasi sinasabi, di ba po, sa balita na hindi, parang pinagpanggap lang. Pero sa tingin ko, totoo yun. Kaya lang yun si Jewel sumuko kasi natakot.
She also revealed their family has been receiving threats from anonymous senders.
Tinatanong po na nag-text ba o tumawag sa inyo yung binaliktad yung pagkasabi ng pangalan ng kapatid ko, binaliktad yung Idoy. Kasi Idoy naman palayaw niya, binaliktad niya. Tapos sabi ko naman, naisip ko, kung kilala namin, hindi ganun ang sasabihin na pangalan.
They have doubts on the ongoing investigation since they have not been allowed to see the remains of her brother. Because she doesn't trust the authorities handling the case, Marissa sought the help of the Tulfo brothers. On Monday, Senator Raffy Tulfo, in his show Tulfo in Action, discussed Marissa's case with Justice Secretary Boying Remulla, who vowed to help the family. Marissa also went to Social Welfare Secretary Erwin Tulfo's office Monday afternoon to seek protection.
Evidently, we asked guidance from Malacanang, and Malacanang was telling me to turn her over to the DOJ under the Witness Protection Program. So that's what we're going to do, na ilalagay siya sa Witness Protection Program. parang care of DSW, the care of Malacañang.
Secretary Tulfo himself accompanied Marisa to the Justice Department so she could be endorsed to the Witness Protection Program.
Nagbigay naman siya ng information at na-determine ho namin na itong information na ito ay sapat na, na malagay siya sa Witness Protection Program dahil ho itong testimony niya or itong statements na binigay niya ay relevant naman ho dun sa kaso natin sa murder no, ni Percy Lapid.
Joyce Balancho, ABS-CBN News.